Patrick, it's not always pretty, right? I mean, how do you characterize like this entire game?
Yeah, I mean, I thought we did a lot of good things, but obviously the three turnovers just can't happen. The first interception, I got to find the backside linebacker, and I mean, the kid made a great play on the second pick. But I'm glad we played not as clean as we wanted to and still found a way to win. That speaks to the defense and the full entire team. But obviously we got to clean up a lot of stuff on offense as we go forward. Yeah, no, obviously they're going to get in that kind of fence defense at the sticks, and so my job is to buy time for guys to get downfield. I was able to do that. As I scrambled to the left, I saw Rasheed open. I knew it was going to be contested, but you got to put the ball up. And Rasheed did a great job of trying to get the ball. I haven't seen the replay or anything, but it felt like the Duquesne was there pretty early, and we got the flag. But, I mean, you got to give guys chances in those situations, and that's what we did.
Out a way?
100%. I mean, I think until you don't have the time hit zero, I feel like there's a chance that you can win the football game. And obviously, we've done that in so many different ways. And so we're prepared. We come in with that mentality that if we get the football with the chance to win the game, we're going to do it. And we were able to do that today.
Patrick, what kind of problems did Trey Henderson
present for you guys? I mean, he's just an absolute monster, man. I mean, like, he just, like, his motor, the way he's able to rush the passer. I remember playing him in New Orleans, and he was like that, and he got to Cincinnati, he's been like that. But he did a great job today, man. He's great against the run in the pass, kind of an underrated guy. But it was a good test for us, and we'll have to get better for it.
What's the other message to Kingsley that you think he'll have throughout the next
7 days? Yeah, I mean, just keep playing, man. And they're not always going to have your perfect day. I mean, I didn't have a perfect day today. But just like any other great player, you have to trust in your abilities. You have to learn from it. You have to have that mentality. I'm going to come and get better this next week. But I have all the trust in the world that he's going to keep getting better and better and be a guy that I can really count on every single game.
Last week and this week, what are you seeing from opposing defense and trying to take Travis Kelce?
Yeah, I know. They're doing a great job of just kind of having two people for him. I mean, pretty much the entire game. That's why you've seen guys like Rasheed and Worthy. I mean, if you look at the first touchdown, I'm actually looking to Trav, and the backside safety goes all the way across the field to help guard Travis, and then you throw the ball down the sideline to Rasheed, and that's kind of what they've been doing. And obviously, we played two opponents, so we've played a lot, so they have a plan on how they're going to account for Travis. But as the season goes on, I mean, he's going to get his catches, he's going to get his yards. But the leader that he is what's special is he's hyping everybody up, he's keeping everybody motivated, and that's what you need out of your great players. Yeah, it was a play where I was actually going to look at the right side first. They gave me a kind of a too high type look. And like I said, I was going to shoot it to Trav in the middle of the field. The backside safety kind of closed in, and that's what got my eyes to Rasheed, and then he won against a great corner. So that's what you want to see. I told y'all, man, he can do a lot of different things, man. And so I'm going to keep giving him opportunities, and he's going to keep making plays. Yeah, I think people obviously saw last week, so they're not gonna let him have those free releases and that the short stuff, and he has to be able to show that he can beat people deep, and he was able to do that today. And then we had the holding, but he did again later at the end of the game. And he's a complete receiver, man. He's getting better and better, and he can do it all. I think people see the short stuff and they get enamored by it, 'cause it's so special when he catches the ball. But he can catch the ball down the field. He can block. He can do everything it takes to be a great receiver in this league. Obviously, it was a great drive. I mean, running the football, getting downhill, and so they have to bring more and more people in the game, bigger people. And Coach Reed dialed it up at the right time. Wanya had been in a couple plays blocking as that extra O lineman, and right when they thought they were just going to shoot and make a play, he released him into the flat. And I mean, if you look at the play, Wanya is open, and I threw, and Travis was also wide open. So that comes with getting the run game going, man. You get the run game going, it helps out the entire offense. Yeah, it just shows that we can still do it. I mean, those are two great football teams we've played these last 2 weeks, teams that we've played in AFC Championship games. And be able to come out with wins at home, that's important. And obviously, we feel like we can get a lot better. And so we're going to clean up the mistakes, especially on the offense. It starts with me, and then we'll be a better team for it as the season goes on. But it'll be a great challenge this next weekend on Sunday Night Football in Atlanta. I mean, I'm nervous, but I'm not nervous. So it's like, I'm obviously nervous because it's out of my hands. I don't have a chance to go out there and make a play. But at the same time, like when I step on the field on that fourth quarter drive with 2 minutes or whatever it is, and all I need is a field goal, I just really know I got to cross the 50 and Harrison's going to go out there and knock it through. It's a special thing to have a kicker like that. Super appreciative of it. He's going to keep making them, man.
Nice.
We'll
come back. Call back against the penalty on Wanye, but can you talk about the play like the old days with you and finding Travis on the run and the great play he made with the football?
Yeah, no, he did a great job. I mean, just you got to be able to have that in the offense, being able to scramble and make throws downfield. Obviously, they were doing a good job of when I scrambled of covering the guys and letting me run, but they lost the Trav for a second. I got him the football, and he's, like, pump faking and stuff. I mean, he's the only person in the league, I think, pump fake, like, 40 yards downfield, but he will throw it. So, I mean, they have to respect it. So, we'll get it going. As the season goes on, I'm sure more of those plays will happen.
You guys did convert a couple fourth downs. They converted fourth downs. But that first drive, I bet you want to go for it down there.
I always want to go for it. So, but obviously with that drive that we had, Coach Reed sent out the field goal unit, and that's what makes us a great team, man. Like, I want the offense to be high-flying and explosive. But I feel like in years past, like if I played like we played today offensively, we would have lost this game. But we have a great football team. Defense stepped up, made plays. Special teams made plays. I'm excited for it. We're not even playing our best football, and we're still getting these wins against great opponents.